Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have did Boyle's law, Charles law, Avogadro law as well as Gay-Lussac law. And based on that concept we are going to do a new thing that is known as early gas equation. So let us do it. So as I have mentioned that ideal gas law is nothing but it is derived by combining basic gas laws, and this basic gas laws are nothing but Boyle's law, Charles law and Avogadro's law. So if we combine this all laws and we can be easily deriving, we could derive that what is ideal gas equation. So let us do with the first one, that is for Boyle's law. Suppose deriving this equation, what we have to make a consideration is that we are taking n moles or specific n moles of the particular gas, and that n number of moles will depend on the change in volume and temperature that will have this kind of factor on it, and because of that we are going to find out ideal gas equation. So in that case, for the first law, that is for Boyle's law, what does Boyle's law indicates? The Boyle's law indicates that volume is inversely proportional to the pressure, or pressure is inversely proportional to the volume, and that also at constant temperature. I will write it here. So in this case, as I have said that I have considered the n number of moles that is constant, that is the number of moles of a gas is been constant. And in this case, suppose I have kept the temperature also constant. So in this case, what I could see is, according to Boyle's law, when I will try to increase the volume, then the pressure will be reduced, or if I increase the pressure, then the volume will be reducing. So therefore they both are basically inversely proportional to each other. So this is nothing but this was for the gas which was undergoing Boyle's law, or which was following Boyle's law. So therefore I would name this equation as equation number one. So now moving towards the next one, that is for Charles law, or according to Charles law. According to Charles law, we know that we have recently did a theory on that, and on that we have learned that the volume of a particular gas having a fixed mass, or as we could say that having a number of moles constant as well as at particular pressure, when the pressure is also constant. So in this case, what we are have observed that when the volume changes, the temperature also changes, or we could say as the temperature changes, the volume also changes, and they both are being directly proportional to each other. So in this case, what I could write it as, the volume is directly proportional to the temperature. So this is what I have wrote. So but this condition was validated when the pressure is constant, and in this overall case the number of moles of gas is also constant. So I would say as at constant n and p. So this equation was for, or this kind of relation was for basically Charles law, when the volume is directly proportional to the temperature at constant pressure and at constant number of moles of gas molecules. So this is the two law, but the thing is the another gas law is also remaining, that is Avogadro's law. So let us do that also. Yes, and according to that is Avogadro's law, we have did a theory on this, and we have also explained a formula that how the formula was been derived between the relation between the two conditions. So I would come directly on this thing, that the volume is directly proportional to the number of moles of the gas. It indicates that if the number of moles of the gas will increase, then volume will also increase for a particular gas, and that condition should be at constant temperature and pressure. So in this case, what I am maintaining is, the temperature, that is T and P, temperature and pressure, the both are being kept constant. So in this case, I would make this equation, or I will make this relation as equation number 3. So in all the equations that we have made, that is, they all were related to volume. So volume was inversely proportional to pressure, the volume was directly proportional to temperature, and in this case the volume is directly proportional to n. So what we are going to do is, we are now equating all the three equations. So let us see what is the thing that we could get. So therefore, equating equation 1, 2 and 3. So from that thing, what we have got as volume was basically inversely proportional to pressure. That was according to Boyle's law. And according to Charles' law, the volume was directly proportional to temperature. And as well as now we could see that according to Avogadro's law, volume is directly proportional to n. So this is the equation that we have got by equating all the three equations, that is equation 1, 2 and 3. So this is the thing that we have got. But as we could see that I could relate this equation as PV, which is directly proportional to NT. So this is the thing that I could do. But again, the proportionality thing has been not been eliminated. So for that, I have to equate this equation as, so because PV is directly proportional to N and T, so there should be a constant that that could equate the pressure volume with the number of moles and temperature. So for that thing, PV is equals to N R T, have made the equation in which the gas is basically constant, and in which R, which is, it is denoted by R, and the R is nothing but the gas constant. So this equation that we have derived by using all the by combining all the three laws is nothing but the ideal gas equation. So let me tell you more about what is ideal gas equation, and let me tell you more about that what is this gas constant and on what it depends actually. So ideal gas are basically are those gas which follows all these three basic laws, that is Boyle's law, Charles' law and Avogadro's law, as well as if we could say that ideal gas is something which obeys ideal gas equation. And in this case, the more important thing that I should tell you is that the volume is something which is can be reducible, means you can decrease the volume of a particular gas by increasing the pressure. But in according to ideal gas, so ideal gas is something for which the number of mole, the number of volume of a particular moles of a particular gas is very negligible compared to that of the total volume of the gas, as well as the pressure as we increase the pressure and as we increase the temperature, there would be no change in volume of the gas, or this kind of ideal gas is not compressible basically. So if, even though if we introduce more pressure, so the volume won't be reduced, and this makes the ideal gas something to be non-compressible gas. But in actual practice, there is no ideal gas available, so it is a hypothetical basically this is a theory that we have made, and that's why the name is ideal gas equation. So all the gases are basically non-ideal gases, or basically they are known as real gases. So this was the equation that had follow the ideal gas equation, and from which we could derive many much more theories based on this law. So this is applicable for all the gases. So this is what we have did, and we have derived an ideal gas equation. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood that how we have derived this equation, and this will be very much influential in the numericals also. So share this video with the friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.